We know when we downloaded part one of the Denver Red-Eyed Stingray, that would bring controversy. Remember on part one, that is clips from three different occasions of sightings that we'd had. We wouldn't have downloaded a video on this object at all if we'd only seen it once. The fact is that we have videotaped this object many times over the past 12 years.
Most video we have taken has been at my father's home in Aurora, Colorado. This was taken from my home around 4 miles away from my father's home. The total sighting lasted about 20 minutes and we got about 9 minutes of video on this object. The really good thing about this video is you could see some shape to the object. You could see some fins on the back and the red eye, which is really amazing, comes out good in this video. Most times we see it, it looks like a bag blowing in the air, something up there just blowing around, but it stays stationary. It can take off. It moves on its own. It's just amazing.
We ask for your help as UFO researchers and witnesses. Help us identify what this object is, and please respond if you have seen this object or a similar object, and any opinions on what you think this is sure appreciated.
We're not recording, are we? Yeah. Oh, sorry. You can see the red eye really good. We're on full digital mode right here. This object was really, really high in the sky, and we'll back off here, and you can see how far out into the atmosphere this object is. Like I say, the really amazing thing in this video is you can see really good shape to it. You can see the red eye. You can see the movement. When I first started videotaping this, it was almost due east from my home, and it moves off to the west where it's at right about now when it's over the trees. We just really like sharing this with everybody.
Before we download any video, we try to do our best to be sure that we're 99.9% sure that this is unidentified. We'll be the first to admit, yeah, we've filmed balloons, we've filmed airplanes way up in the sky, we've even filmed the planet Venus during the daytime. But we just feel that's been part of our learning experience over these years of being UFO hunters.
To everybody out here watching this video, we just want you to know, we're just a couple of good old boys. We ain't trying to pull the wool over anybody's eyes. Really, we really would like some insight from other viewers out there and what this might be. We've been sighting this for over 12 years. We've got a lot of video of it. We know something up there that's just blowing around from, you know, this is a real object up there.
Remember, as you're watching this video, that this is clips from a single sighting that my son had seen from more than 20 minutes, and he had videotaped it for more than 9 minutes. And we had to clip it down a little bit. You'll notice that the object appears translucent, not transparent, but translucent at times, and you can always see the fins and the red eye.
It's moving behind the trees right now, so you could see the movement of what it's doing. Like I say, it's not like something up there that's just totally out of control. This thing is controls its movement. Like I say, from time to time, when it moves from one part of the sky to the other, it will do it rapidly. And other times, it will just sit there. This is really good showing that the movement of it, and it just doesn't move from east to west or north to south. It can change directions whenever it wants to.
The reason that we decided to download these, when we first filmed the object, we said, gee, people's going to say that's a sack flipping in the sky or whatever. This is one good-sized object. And you can see here, we're getting pretty close to it. It's way up in the sky. And as my son said, we want to share these with people, and we want you to share our videos with other people. We just enjoy going out and looking at the skies and filming things.
One thing I find kind of interesting after doing some research on this object is seeing some of the photos from NASA, and they show, I guess they call it an amoeba or something like that. But this object shows a lot of the characteristics of what they're getting from the NASA photographs. And here's a still of the object that you were just seeing. And kind of compare, if you've looked at the NASA photos, compare it with the thing that they're getting up there on their videos.
And coming up, you're going to see a couple more stills. And we said compare these with the NASA photos and give us your comments. Thank you so much.